My name is Tomas Gonzalez. I am born and raised Bostonian in the city of Boston. Over the last 2 years, I was introduced to Joanna Marinova from a friend of mine from college. And it was through conversations that I had with her that I ended up going to Old Colony Correctional Facility. It was a casual conversation. I was talking about the things that I wanted to focus on in my campaign last year. And you know, one of them was around violence and youth violence. I decided to do it because, you know, having grown up in rough neighborhoods doesn't necessarily make you, you know, extremely aware about what crime is or, you know, how that impacts people's lives and incarceration and the whole nine. So I wanted to take, I thought, what would be one a first step in a journey to understanding that better and being able to, you know, one, reconcile it for myself, but two, be an advocate for the types of changes that we need moving forward. My first impression was he's a serious, you can tell he's a serious guy. You know, it's one of the first things I got from him. He's very serious, he's extremely knowledgeable. And I really got a sense of, you know, his passion for the work that he sort of does, how things can happen better if there was more communication between, I guess, the inside and the outside. Personally speaking, one, I approached people a little differently, just how I dealt with him and how he approached me. Because more often than not, you're sort of very standoffish with people, but he was very, let's get to it. You know, let's talk frankly about what we, you know, what the subject is. He was able to sort of paint a picture for you that made sense and then put you in it. Because that's, I think that's a big difference. It's nice to paint a picture with someone else's life, but he's here. He took me out of my comfort zone and put me in that situation. And I think that that's probably, you know, one, it's a gift because not many people can do that for you. But two, it was probably the best learning experience and the most real learning experience I've had throughout the entire campaign. Because I actually, like I said, left my comfort zone, got out of what I wanted, you know, where I would normally be, and went into somewhere where I had no knowledge, no experience, and to have gained so much from it was amazing. And every time I spoke about it, and he was right, one of the things he said is that now you can walk away saying you've met a convicted criminal and you've had conversations about these issues. And he was right, you know, I could walk away and say that now, and convincingly. And then a lot of what, you know, a lot of little tidbits he dropped, you know, because he likes to plant seeds. So a lot of what he said would, you know, like germinating in my mind. And it's like, seriously, you know, I was like, man, I remember he said this, and either it happened or it didn't happen, or something related to it happened, you know. So he was very good at, you know, helping me as an individual become stronger around this issue and to actually be, I think, better as a candidate overall, because it wasn't just youth violence. He talked about the economy. I mean, he talked about a lot of things, education, all things that I thought were really important to me and to my campaign. He had an opinion on, was familiar with. You know, he's a very well-learned person. So I think that people in elected office or public office or in some appointed office should visit prisons, especially if they're gonna be dealing with violence and things that are going on in the city. Absolutely. I mean, for me, it was the biggest eye-opener in the world. And because, you know, one, you should see how people deal with it, how people are treated, and the kinds of improvements that you can really make. You almost had to pull yourself away from it and sort of come back to it in a different way, because I think we all have the good intentions, but this is not about good intentions, it's about making things right so that people can move forward with their lives. So, you know, I think that, you know, between my own personal and sort of my macro look on an issue that I had a little bit of knowledge about, I think sort of changed how I sort of, well, it changed completely how I saw the issue and how I address people with respect to that issue and any other issue at that point.